Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari here in the Palace of Saren, as you can see. I found something. I didn't figure this out. I tried a few more things that didn't work, and then I decided to start looking around the room. There's spinners that are annoying, but... you know, like that. West is good, though. I like West. That's where we... I found this. This sphere. Wait, no. Not the way it's... In the crystal ball, you can see the number 75. So maybe... I don't know. If there's some more crystal balls, maybe he wants the sum of the... what is all together. Maybe that's what that means. So... 75... And then... I come back out. And then maybe on this side there's another. There is. In the crystal ball you can see the number 46. So does he want the sum of those numbers, or is there more stuff? East. Well, I had west. Any? Are there any more? Has me wait, wait a second. Here's another one. Is that the same one? I don't think that's the same one. So here we go south to get out. Oh, no, that's another 75. Write that down. That spins me. It's trying to stop me from getting to these crystal balls. One on the side. So I'm hoping it's just four. Oh, another 46. All right, so with the 75s, we got 150. And then... 46 and 46 is 92. Doing it right, 242. Back to the magic mouth. North, yes, but we have to go a little bit this way. And not that much that way. Front 242. The Stonehead says, the way before you is open. More magical guards pour out. Nothing seeing us yet. There's another magic mouth. Okay, we just got moved by another spinner. Wait. West? Oh. All right. Yeah. Yeah, same old magical guards. I'll be speeding up the combat as usual with these guys. Only this side to change it up a bit or something. He can just jump over here. It's too far away. Really? He can jump over such... I didn't know that. I'd rather have him attack. Nice. Okay, Edgel, level 35, but his life points didn't go up, but you have 67 training points. Oh my god! Edgel has 7 attacks per round. That's amazing. I wonder what's the top of that. You know, like, how many attacks per round can we go? Alright, just take it in the room here. Save, just in case. Thank you, but I really just want to go this way. Any more secrets? There's another magic mouth over there. It might want... to know what's in other magic globes. Okay, heading north. Right, I don't find anything there. Huh. In the crystal ball, you can see the number 1. Link to another page in my little post-it notes. We got 1. That's... not even hidden? Wait a second. How do I get out of here again? So when I look back, yeah, it is a secret wall. Alright. There's the magic mouth. Or it's actually a riddle mouth. Monster see me. Ah! I think I went through a wall there. An illusory wall. But, then we have these things. I'm just really gonna try to put them to sleep, if at all possible. Stop them from hitting us. We were lucky last time. No critical hits in the last battle. Nice. Called in level 38. Life points did not go up. And power points did not go up. 91 spell learning points and 209 training points. And he already had 3 attacks per round. So when you hear the music stop, that means I'm just, like, basically pressing stop and start because I'm trying to make it easier for myself when I edit so that I can edit, like, speed up the parts that, as you have been seeing. I wish I had use of the map. I think I was trying to go this way. Find the next little orb. Oh god. Yep. These battles over and over again. Try to put them to sleep. I just want to show you guys something really quick. We got the critical hit. He knocks the train down from full, or almost full, because it didn't hit him. Hit her like once or twice before that. It was his final hit, which knocked her down to 12 hit points. Crazy. And I'm glad she didn't die. That's why I'm just continuously healing people. I'm pretty sure these two are still asleep. We're not attacking them. I'm gonna try to put this guy to sleep at least for a little bit as well. And the medium really isn't gonna do it. So I'm also gonna use a healing potion 3 on Citrine as well. It still didn't give, even those two together did not give her all the way up. Almost though. And now they're all asleep. Well, she's, we're hitting him now. Oh, he's dead. Okay, cool. So now, small healing for Citrine. Now we just wail on this guy. And I'm gonna keep throwing sleep spells at him. In case he wakes up from us wailing on him with swords and stuff. I'm gonna put him back to sleep again. Okay. Is this where we originally came in? No. Was I heading north? That wall just looked fake, I don't know. Oops. Team. Recording the number. Heading south. There's another magic mouse. This is where we came in. This is the magic mouth that we solved. Opened up. I'm not sure where I've been and where I haven't, but yeah, I was so used to using the map to get through. So number one. Okay, I'm not sure. That's the same one, so I put a question mark. Thinking. Yeah. Forgot how to get out again. I guess it's... we get out through this adjoining room? There is no adjoining room. Okay. I'm out? Right, so that... was to the north. I think we've seen that already. We're heading south now. And then... okay, sure. It was over here. I just want to see if it's the same one. Northwest-ish. Getting lost in this place. Wasn't that to the north? And I had found another ball to the south, I thought. This is the south. Unless it's along this wall. Getting kind of northish. Wait. Okay. 15. That's a different one. So maybe there is two ones. Because they were duplicate numbers the other way as well. That we had two 75s and two 46s. East. Let's see what it says. The Stonehead asks, what is all together if there are balls below the line and columns after a cross? What? What does that mean? Well, the balls, I guess it means the sphere. Balls below the line? What's the line? And columns after a cross. What are... What cross? And I guess it doesn't mean these are columns. And this is the other place we ended up. That column? What do you mean by after a cross, though? So that kind of column? Look at this with the rock here. Three rocks. Look at that. Is that significant? Well, the three rocks apparently indicate a spinner. I am not liking this at this point. Did I break through into somewhere? No. Is the place shaped like a cross? Because it kind of is. You go north, and then there's these two rooms to each side. This one and the other one I was just in. That's a spinner there, right? Forward. Wait. Oh, I found a 19 before. So I don't know if it's another 19. Below a line. What line? There's spheres, yeah, but there's no line. Unless he's just talking about the layout of the place, which I can't really see in my head, because... Okay, that was to the north. So then, I'm going south now, so there's got to be another one somewhere... to the south, right? But I think I was just over here. I mean, not necessarily, there has to be. Back north. Wait. Wait. 67. That's the missing one. I don't think the 19... I think the 19 and the 1 I had already seen. So 67. And... there's one column in here. One. Let's write down the columns. Okay, we're heading north to get out. What if the cross signifies adding, and the line indicates subtracting? This is where we came in, right? Yeah. Alright, so we've got 1, 2, 3... four columns in here. Five? Right, I'll make sure I can see everything. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's 5 in here. And there's 1 in the other room. That room, right, has 1. And then this way, west. One column. There's another one back here. Heading south. So there's another. There's 5 in the entry room. And then there's 1 on each side. It's turning me, and I'm just trying to write stuff down. Do you mind? Okay, so that's not the way out. I'm getting all turned around now. So I can't see the map, can't see where I am. Please, get me out of the room, or stuff's running out. Rapidly. Okay. What is all together, meaning the sum, right? If there are balls below the line and columns after a cross. Okay, balls below the line. So meaning when you add something together, the line that goes, you know, you've got like 2 plus 3 and then the line across and then there's the sum, right? So we're going to add the balls together, I think, which is going to be 20, 35, I'm just going to calculator. Right, so you got 1 and 19 is 20, 15 is 35, and then adding in 67 is 102, I believe. For the things. And and then columns after a cross. unless we're supposed to add that together as well, then that would be... ...109. That is not the right answer. ...102 is the things put together, no? That's all the spheres. 102 minus 7? 95? No. And for all I know, I miss spheres as well. 102... Hold on, 102... I can't even do this anymore. 102... divided by 7 columns? It's not even a whole number. It's 14.571428 blah 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 blah. 14... I doubt it's this, because... 14, wait a second. Point... 5... No. I haven't seen anything that dealt with fractions or decimal places. What was I saying it was? Oh, 14.57. Alright, that's not it. So... come on. Just trying to get rid of what we have. 102 times 7? Sorry about the clicking. 714. Balls? Yeah, I hope the other places aren't like this. We have like 4 more palaces after this. What is all together if there are balls below the line? Columns after a cross. So plus columns, right? And balls below? Alright, sorry guys, this was killing me. I was right about a couple things. I did look up the answer. So it's the sum of all the numbers visible on the 8 crystal balls, which is should be 344. That's what it says anyway. So just let me just do it on my calculator as well, so I can do it. Okay. Things are fighting me here. Things are fighting me! Alright, where's my calculator? Oop. Alright, so the sum of all the crystal balls. Alright, so 75... and 75 is 150. Hold on a second. 150 plus 46 plus 46, 242. That's the front 242 I had before, so I know it's the right answer. And then plus 1 plus 19 plus 15 plus 67. 344 I should have? Yes. Okay, the sum of numbers visible on all crystal 8 balls is 344. So then you want to take that and divide it by the sum of the crystal balls. Sorry about the popping. Whenever I move my head around, it's doing that. So, stop that. So, divided by 8. I think I did it right. It's giving me a fraction. Hold on a second. Or it's giving me a number with a decimal. So 344, I just want to clear this out. 344 divided by 8. Oh, I didn't have it right. Okay. Divided by 8 is actually 43. And then... you want to times it by 7. I was right about the columns. So I had 5 in the first room, and then 1 in the left, and then 1 in the right room. So 7. So 43 times 7 equals 301. And that's the number that it should be. That's the same thing the walkthrough is saying. And I did not read ahead or anything, so all I know is it's 301. That's all I wanted to know. The Stonehead says the way before you is open.